Good evening, welcome. I'm Laura Antonia Jordan. I'm the fashion and lifestyle features director of Grazia. It's a mouthful. I'm here with Paloma Faith, but I don't think she needs any introduction to any of you. I don't need to tell you that she's multi-platinum, Brit Award winning, actor, singer, on tour later this year. And as you know, as you can see this evening, Paloma is so loved for her sense of style as well. Something which she's translated into Paloma Home earlier this year. And now she has this beautiful collection of sofas and accessories with Sofology. And we're going to have a little chat about the collaboration. I always like to start by asking everybody when we interview them, like, how are you? And I think it's really more important than ever this year. So how are you?
I feel excited about going back out on tour. I feel really privileged and excited to be able to launch this range of things because, I'll just start talking about it, but people were coming to my house a lot, and I'm a big fan of vintage and going to like flea markets and stuff, and people would come to my house all the time and were saying, how do you think of putting all these things together? And they just go, like, why do they go together? I'd never think of that. So they were like, can you help me with my house? And then all these people started to ask me, and I thought, oh, maybe I should design something that doesn't need much help, because the idea behind it is that everything in it goes together, even if you don't think it does. So you can buy like any specific, you know, non-specific combination of items from the range, and they sort of look quite good together. And that it's based on my own house, so people are always like, why did you think to put those things? Because I wouldn't have thought that, and it looks like it shouldn't work, but it does. And that's what I wanted to do, was like make something that takes the thinking part away.
Yeah, and I think it just invites people to have fun with it and not take it so seriously. Yeah. Which is how I feel about getting dressed as well, you know. Mm. It should be easy, but there's not always these rules that we have to necessarily follow. When you do go, I mean, we've all spent a lot more time at home in the last, yes, however long it's been. And what does home mean to you? You said a bit about how it looks. Is it somewhere that would normally be bustling with people coming in and out? Or
my house is quite busy because there's like always people coming in. There's like the doorbell just goes all day with deliveries and whatever. In fact, as I left the house today, my boyfriend was like, please do not bring any more kitchens into this house. Like, there's too many. And no more prams. obviously we spent a lot of time at home during lockdown, and that was when this all started. I started putting the range together during that time because I don't know about anyone else here, but I just started looking around my house, noticing every floor imperfection, and also the corners of the house that made me happy, that I would just hide in and be like, everything feels okay in this bit. And so wanted to like make my whole house feel like that, and sort of sense of security. And also because my house is chaotic, like I've got a baby and a child and people coming in and out all the time, it's always getting into a mess. So I wanted the range to, on a practical level, be the sort of range that still looks good when there's a mess everywhere. So yeah, so that's what I wanted to do, is just make the chaos part of the whole experience rather than fleeing from the chaos and then constantly having to make your house look like MTV Cribs, which I would be incapable of because I like to leave my pants on the floor.
Yeah, you're not the only one. Everyone says my house looks very good on Zoom. I'm like, that's because you can only see this bit.
Yeah, I actually did a shoot in my house once for Architectural Digest, and they came and they were like scratching their heads like, ooh, how can we make this look like a show home, and basically just removed everything from every corner to make it look, so if you've ever seen them pictures, it just looks really perfect, and it really doesn't look like that in real life.
Well, there you go. Considered chaos, I think we should call it.
Yes.
Okay. And what do you think is the most surprising thing we'd find in your home?
Well, there's lots of... I don't think anyone would be surprised, because you think of me and you think nothing's really a surprise. But my two favourite items springing to mind right now are some gold taps on the bath that are the same as Liberace's.
Second mention of Liberace.
They're like the swan, gold. Obviously, anybody who's nouveau riche would understand. I've got, for potty training, a replica miniature toilet, which is complete with a flush, like the sound of a flush. It's not a real flush. But when I trained her, I've kept it for the next one, but when I trained it, it's like a tiny little white one. It's that big. I really like mini things.
That is sweet. And we're all endlessly moved by tiny things, aren't we? Whoever we are. Okay, so we're allowed guests inside again, but lots of us have forgotten how to host, although I feel a bit like I'm hosting this evening.
Yeah.
What are your tips to making people feel welcome when they come round to Casa Paloma?
Making them feel welcome. I sort of feel like that's me that does that rather than the house. I'm just like, come in. I usually put a drink straight in their hands as soon as they walk in. And I'm a big feeder, so I love cooking. But I love cooking and entertaining, so... I like to sort of make everything feel like a celebration. So if people are coming round, it's almost like their birthday or Christmas. Like, I'll decorate. I'm really fond of a paper garland. And I like to colour coordinate, like, my decorations. I always have a helium canister downstairs. Balloons are very important. Even if it's not a celebration, every day could be a celebration. And actually, at the moment, it does feel like every time someone comes round, it's a celebration, because for ages we couldn't.
Mm-hmm. I think it's reminded us to celebrate the ordinary.
Yeah.
And that you're very privileged to have the ordinary.
Yeah, totally.
So you said you were inspired to launch Paloma Home sort of because people kept asking you, by your own approach to style, which feels quite instinctive and eclectic. And now you've launched sofas.
Yeah.
Why did the opportunity to work with Sofology, particularly on this collection, appeal to you?
You know, like, sometimes if we spend a lot of time at home, it gets a bit stale and you're like, I just want to change up. What we do is take all the bit modules in our house and sort of move them into different bits, so it sort of either opens up a room or closes it up, so you can have, like, say you've got a big room, you can divide it into half and then turn another half into, like, I don't know what you fancy, like reading or something. Well, ours is like children's play there and then our telly bit there, but you can make the corner sort of separate it so that they know, stay back. And then when they get older, you can open it out and have all the space. And I do that with my sofa. So I was just, I was very excited about making it in bits. They did that a lot in the 70s, and 70s is quite a big inspiration for this collection. But it sort of either can make a little area of the room, or it could, like a sort of pod, or it can open it up.
Yeah, and I'm not just saying this, they are very comfortable. I'm on my best behaviour sitting
also,
like this.
I know this is like really crap, but they really look more expensive than they are.
which much
appeals to me.
How I really want to sit is kind of like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so the collection includes three styles, the rock and roll,
yeah,
the Lady Muck and the offbeat Chesterfield. Can you tell me a bit about the inspirations, but either behind the whole collection or any of the specific styles?
Yeah, well, the names are sort of funny, because Lady Muck would was what my mum used to call me when I was a kid. If I asked for something tiny little bit, not pop, like if it was a tiny bit posh, like crust cut off or something. All right, Lady Mark. And so that's where that came from, because it does look quite a little bit posh. And then the rock and roll thing is like, you know, I said the 70s inspiration. It's sort of like that kind of like bohemian, faded grandeur, opulence thing. This wallpaper is my favourite because it's inspired by a film called In the Mood for Love, which is one of my favourite films. And I spent ages trying to find this wallpaper for my own house and couldn't find it. So then I was like, can we run that? So now I've got a million rolls of it in my house because I'm going to go over the wall with it. So they're all inspired by different things. But as I said, the main inspiration is really just sort of trying to create a bit of a canvas for you to buy all the bits. And then when next time you go to like a secondhand shop or your charity shop or whatever, anything you buy in there, I assure you will look right in your house if it's already Paloma Home is like the framework.
I know there are many people who have a headache choosing the right sofa, which is something that
I thought you were going to say, have a headache looking at it.
Yeah.
There's many people who've got migraines.
Do you know,
now.
I know people that have had borderline breakdowns about choosing a sofa because it feels like such a big decision. Mm. What advice would you give to anyone that was looking for a new sofa right
I don't have those breakdowns. If it feels comfortable to sit on, and this really does, my advice is go for it, because once you've bought it, you can't backtrack. The only problem is like when people buy sofas that aren't comfortable, and that confuses me. My mum does it all the time. I don't think she's ever had a comfortable sofa in my entire life. And every time we sit down on any sofa she's ever had, she's always apologising for how uncomfortable it is. I don't really know what that's about, but so these are comfortable. So just buy any of them and stop worrying. That's my advice.
Yeah. Just enjoy it.
And then if you make a mistake in life, you just own it. Stick some more cushions on top.
Well, yeah, you know, you're the second person I've spoke to this week who's had a cushion habit. I'll tell you the other one is later. What was your favourite part of the design process?
I really like scrapbooking and stuff. So I used a lot of the scrapbooks that I had made for my own house. And then I just sort of built on them. But I find it really inspiring, and I got loads of ideas from doing it. So changed my own house in the process a bit because I was finding all these images that I liked so much.
I think that's a good tip as well for interiors, is that you can see it as an evolving space. Mm. So there actually isn't really much of a thing as making a mistake.
Yeah, exactly.
It's always changing. You can grow and, yeah, evolve, as I say. Okay, so hopefully we're looking forward to Nights In again, now that it will be a novelty and not an obligation. Mm. What would a night in with Paloma on the sofa look like? How do you unwind and relax?
I've actually got a video projector, so I like to pretend that I'm in the cinema. Well, I just like project it onto like, we get bulldog clips and just put a white sheet up and then project film onto that. And because my daughter's four, so she loves it, we pretend it's the cinema, and then we do like popcorn and we write like a big sign, and then she'll serve everyone. Like,
that's the best, that's the ingenious
little pots
bit.
Of ice cream. Oh my God, don't they feel posh?
Mini again.
Yeah, mini things. And yeah, that's the sort of thing I like to do. Pretend I'm in the cinema at home.
Can I come?
Yeah.
I think
with a duvet.
Oh yeah, bliss.
Duvet on the sofa is the best thing.
Thank you so much. I think we have a few questions from the audience. Yeah. Yes.
What tips would you give to someone who's looking to reboot their home on a budget?
What I do if I don't want to like spend loads but want to reboot is there's some really good, well, cushions, obviously, because these ones are not, they're £30 each, or roughly. And so you can get a few new cushions, change them. I also think flea markets. There's one in London called Kempton Racecourse, which is like a really good one where if you've put on a Cockney accent or have one like me a bit, you can haggle, and they love it. And they're really like, will go down, which is my favourite thing. Just can't stop the hustle. and I love, what else do I love to do? So there's some really amazing fake flowers out now. Now, I know that, because I think real flowers wonderful and everything, but the water stinks if you forget to change it. So there's some really good fake ones, and you could like put, you know, some fake flowers. Also, love a big plant, Columbia Flower Road. The flower market's good for, if you go at the end of the day, if you're on a budget, they're always selling everything off cheap at the end because they don't want to take it back. So that's a good time to go.
That's a good tip.
Thank you.
So if you could invite anyone to take a seat on each of these sofas with you, who would you choose and why?
Mae West. The best quotes ever. So like, she would be, she's full of one-liners. Anyone like that, her or what's her name? Diana Vreeland, who used to be the editor of Vogue, and she used to have brilliant one-liners. Like, if you said to her, somebody once asked her if she loved vintage, and she said, "Darling, I don't believe in anything before penicillin." But like, everything was vintage. I'd like someone like her or Mae West. Very similar approach. Bit like early feminists, but there was no feminism around then. But they were ahead of the curve.
Do you have any advice on how to style the pieces? So, for example, the leopard print is quite bold. So how would you introduce that?
Well, I think, first of all, you need to challenge your own obstacles that you've obviously placed in your mind about leopard print. It's a neutral, and anyone who says it isn't is lying. So, great, everything goes with neutrals, and then you're all right. I do believe that animal prints are neutrals, because if you look at the world and, you know, all the wild animals, and imagine, you know, the real leopards and real tigers, they look good in any scenario because they're beautiful living things, just like the way a plant makes a room look amazing because it's a beautiful living thing. A fake, might I add, animal's covering will look good in any scenario.
Thank you very much. And we have one more, I think.
What's the best advice you've ever been given when it comes to interior design?
Well, because most of the time people say things like, "Oh, don't get that, that doesn't go with that." And especially my mum, she's very into like 60s minimalism. She's like, whitewash everything and just like have minimal, bare minimum. And I'm like, no, that sounds awful. So the best advice is that I would give you is don't listen to advice. And if you like something, just go with it and don't worry about what other people say, basically.
I love that. And that's a perfect note to end on.
Yeah.
Permission granted to do what that.
If they don't like it, tell them to go to somebody else's house.
There you go. You're the one that has to live with it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Paloma. It's been a real joy. Thank you, everybody, for coming.